Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMI RPG and SQL sample video. When we take the step of starting to use SQL instead of using the native RPG operation to read files, we sometimes find ourselves with a lot of doubts regarding cursors. A cursor is nothing more than an open path to, for example, read a file. That means that if we open and close cursors, it is the same as if we open and close files. That is, by using SQL, we can cause the same problems as we used native open and close operations, if we don't do them correctly. Therefore, it is important to know how to reuse these cursors, not only within my program, but as long as the activation group does not end. In this video, I show you an example of how we can easily reuse a cursor. Let's go. I had prepared a small program that reads records from a file using a cursor. Let me show it to you. Okay, as you see, it is very simple. There are some important things I need you to see. If you notice, the program is a program without cycle. Okay. On the other hand, the program works in the activation group of the caller program. Therefore, if it is called from the activation group, it will be executed in the activation group. And if not, then in the activation group from which you are calling. Okay, you can also see here that I'm not using the commit control. Okay, well, the program opens a cursor and reads it until it finds no more records and writes the results to the job log. If you notice, at no time do I close the cursor. In the program compilation options, we have to take this into account because, for example, in my case, by default, the close sqlcsr option appears with end mode. That means that the open cursors will be closed automatically at the end of the program. Therefore, every time you run the program, the cursor will open, the file will be read, and then when we finish, it will close. What happens if we want to keep the cursor open? In that case, we can change the program option and put end activation group, so that the cursor does not close until the activation group ends. Be careful with this, because if the activation group is closed after each execution, we are in the same situation as before. So let me run the program so you can see how it works. Let me start it with a debug session. Okay, so let me stop it here. Let's run the program. And as you see, I'm now opening the cursor. We can see in the job log that the cursor has been opened. Okay. And then we are fetching every record and I'm writing it into the job log until the SQL code variable is different than zero. Then I leave and the program ends. Okay, so if I see my job log, I can see all the execution. I have opened here the cursor and then I'm reading every of the rows of the file and I'm writing the results to the job log. Okay, and when I'm not finding any row, any more row, the program is ending and the SQL cursor is closed. Okay, so if I run the program again, then I will get the same result. Okay, and also if I see I don't have any file open. Okay, imagine that I want to keep my cursor open after every execution. What can I do then? Well, then I can change the options. So let me change the program and let me add this option, this is the same as if I write this option in the compilation command, okay? And now let me compile it again, okay? And let's try to run it again. Let's run it. I'm opening the cursor. Okay, the cursor has been opened. And I'm running the program until the end. Okay, what's the difference between this and the option before? Well, the difference is that the file is still open. Why? Because I have not closed the cursor. What happened if I run the program again? Let's go. Let's try to open the cursor. And what I'm getting is this. Cursor is already open. Okay. Well, let's try to continue. SQL code has this value, but as I have here a do until, I can go inside and then I'm going to fetch. What happens then? Well, what is happening is that I'm not reading any row. Okay, why? Because in the previous execution, if you see, I reach to the last row and the cursor is still open. So the next element that I'm reading is the next row and there's no more rows. Okay. So the program ends. What can I do then? Well, to solve this problem, we can declare this cursor as a scroll cursor. Thus, we can indicate at the beginning from which point we want to read the file. It's more or less like doing a set LL. So let me change the program. We are going to change here okay, scroll cursor. And now the first thing we have to do is, after opening it, is fetching first from C1. Okay, this way I'm indicating that we want to read the first record of the cursor. Okay, and then we need to change the loop. Okay, I can change it to do while, and I'm gonna write this before, and I will fetch it, and I don't need this anymore. Okay, so the program is completely the same, but I have changed the cursor for a scroll cursor. Okay, so if I run the program, let me compile it. Okay, so let me stop the program here. Let's run it. And well, the first execution, I'm opening the cursor. Let me see, the file is now open. Okay, I'm fetching the first record. And ID and name has value, so SQL code is 0. Okay, I'm writing it into the job log, and I'm fetching the next element. So I will do this until we reach SQL code. It's different than 0. Okay, and if I see my job log, I am getting this. I'm reading one row, two rows, three rows, four rows, and when I'm reaching the last element, the program ends. Okay, what happens now with my file? Well, okay, the file is still open, so we can run the program again. Okay, I'm gonna try to open the cursor again. I'm getting an error because the cursor is still open. And if I do now the fetch first, then I'm not getting an error. I'm getting this message, one row fetched from cursor C1. Okay, and what's the ID that I have read? It's the same. It's the first record, okay? So the program is reusing correctly the cursor, okay? So I can run the program all the times I need. It is not opening and closing the files. The file is still open, so we don't have to open and close files in this case. Okay, of course, we can change the program here to put, for example, an activation group, for example, with this name. I can compile the program. And if I run the program, well, let me close the activation group, ending the session. If I now execute the program, then I will get the same, but if I see the files is still open, but it is open in a different activation group than the default activation group. Okay, so I can, of course, I can run it again. It will work. Okay, and for closing the cursors, I can reclaim the activation group this way. And this way, I will close the files. Okay. Well, as you can see, it is very useful to use scroll cursors because we can leave them open between executions and read them again as many times as we need without having to do the costly file opening and closing operations. Of course, if we also play with the activation groups, we can leave the file open in a specific activation group and close it if we need it at any time. I hope the video has been useful to you. Remember to like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.